2019 has been a roller coaster of both positive and negative, by far the most significant year in my life. I've helped thousands of people improve their health through a variety of videos, such as Strictly Educational, Days of Eating. Even correcting vegans and having a little bit of fun can stray people from an incorrect path to improve their well-being. I'd like to touch on the most significant videos I've done, as well as corresponding events. Keep in mind, guys, I do a video every day. So although there are at least, 10 to 15 excellent videos every month, I will be highlighting my few favorites. This year started off with World Carnivore Month, and there was definitely more hype around the carnivore diet last year than there is now. My raw versus cooked video is something I constantly reference. That was the first educational video we did this year, going over the pros and cons, as well as the necessity of both raw and cooked foods in your diet. Bone broth is something that I've been pestered about from time to time, and people still ask about it, and so I needed to touch on it. Fruits and vegetables aren't healthy goes into the fact that plant foods don't contain the nutrients that our bodies need. That was when my channel was really blowing up, seeing the most growth. Some days I was getting over 1,000 subscribers. I was kind of just hoping that it would never stop. I guess it was partly due to all the drama that month as well. Bonnie Rebecca no longer being vegan, one of my most popular videos, and then Vegan Gains' channel was taken down towards the end of January. The drama got bigger and bigger. I was still doing ex-vegan interviews at the time, and one of the girls actually met up with Sverige, basically exposing him for eating cooked meat as well as drinking water. Nothing wrong with that, as I do them, but Sverige is known for being very critical of anyone that eats cooked food, drinks water. He proclaims that water is toxic, that cooked food is toxic, yet he does it himself. So it's a bit hypocritical, when you're doing one thing and telling people another. If you guys missed my Natural Glow makeup tutorial, you'll find out what Frankie Boy would look like if he actually wore makeup. I did a video on mewing, facial posture, explaining that facial development is determined by diet, not just posture. I explained tanning beds, whether or not you can use them to increase your vitamin D3 status. Then the same girl that did my makeup in that makeup tutorial ended up putting a fake beard on me, which I used for a video where I was explaining that I raised my testosterone naturally on a carnivore diet. Towards the end of February, there were some more very important videos on calcium, plant versus animal vitamins, as well as high meat. It was a bit of drama back and forth between myself and Vegan Gains. As you can tell by the thumbnails, we were having debates, and I actually started my fitness trial at this point in time, which no one ended up following through with. Apple cider vinegar, iodine, as well as scurvy are three videos that I am very proud of, and I had plans for debunking the three aspects of veganism pretty extensively: health, environment, and morals. We did the plant versus animal vitamins for the health aspect, we did a video on the environment, and then we did the morals video. I ended up having my second debate with Vegan Gains around the time that Ravana was caught eating fish. So again, a lot of drama towards early spring, the end of that winter. Shortly after that, Raw Alignment as well as Tish Wonders gave up on veganism, and then I had a follow-up debate with Vegan Gains. Around the time, Rat Boy reached out to me to collaborate, and after I watched some of his videos, I realized the carnivores were copying my content. That video of, the first one exposing them wasn't received too well at the time, and it wasn't really clear they were paid shills. On a more positive note, that was when I started the Perfected Health podcast. Great first episode with Ivor Cummins on heart disease. The one thing I regret missing in that first podcast was talking about how you need to have high blood pressure to get heart disease. Would have been interesting to hear his feedback on that. So now we're at about the end of March. Already quite a bit has happened, especially making a video a day. My Fish is a Double-Edged Sword video is a must watch. I also did a fairly funny skit as Frankie Fennel on vegan rabbit diets, how they should be eating their own doo-doo. Sverige got arrested for eating a raw squirrel, complete nut job. I debunked the methionine to glycine nonsense that people were using to sell collagen supplements, yet that is still present and people are always talking about it. It seems to have stuck with their BS. Then I went over some indigenous oat preparations, including oat milk and traditional Scottish porridge. From 2016 to the beginning of 2019, I was making my own YouTube thumbnails, and they weren't that great. You know, they were just bold text on random pictures taken out of the video. I did end up paying someone for a month or two to do my thumbnails more professionally, and then he had some personal health issues and couldn't do it anymore. So on a whim, I learned Photoshop, and then my thumbnails took a little bit of a step up. You know, I had fun with a few of them, you know, putting like cauliflower brains on vegans. Coinciding with me learning Photoshop, I launched Frankie's Free Range Meat on Kickstarter. I remember one of the first thumbnails I was Photoshopping was actually for the Frankie's Free Range Meat video. I was also chewing mastic gum, and my jaw was swollen as hell for a few weeks. My first vegan event also occurred. A lot of stuff going on. That was the Veggie Pride Parade in New York City. I attended that with one of my viewers. It was actually his idea. Coincidentally, my Kickstarter for Frankie's Free Range Meat was taken down 1 week later, likely mass reported by vegans. I did a video covering the life of a feedlot cow, how they don't actually spend most of their life on grass. We touched on the healthiest plant foods, at least ones that I deem healthy. Here is my fourth carnivore goes vegan for a day. You know, me having fun as a flamboyant vegan banana lover. We did a couple of those this year, and I think we did two last year as well in 2018. Then I made a 45-minute video on the pros and cons of dairy. By far the most educational piece I have ever seen on dairy. And I mean, I probably should have sold it as a video course, but you know, the more people I can help, the better. We were rolling out with products on Frankie's Free Range Meat, you know, to keep order volume high. You know, after the Kickstarter was taken down, we ended up getting a website up, which the vegans also tried to take down, but they weren't successful that time. Farage and Vegan Gains had a debate in the beginning of May, because after those vegans got my Kickstarter taken down, I started ignoring them. I introduced you guys to my brother and sister at that time as well. I think my brother was visiting for some reason. And then I did a really good video, how to get started on the carnivore diet, which is a great overview of the basics, everything you need to do to get your macronutrients and micronutrients correct. We covered grounding, the importance of vitamin D3, coffee, as well as cheese. I spent quite a bit of time researching how to reverse arterial calcification, some great points in that video. We covered digestive systems of carnivores versus herbivores, then officially launched Frankie's Naturals, my hygiene and cosmetic products that I had been working on and selling since 2018. This was when we started filling the orders for Frankie's Free Range Meat, which was a bit of a fiasco at the start. Definitely shouldn't open a meat company in the hottest week in summer. Beyond Meat started gaining traction at this time, and there was a lot more vegan propaganda, you know, Billie Eilish, media blitzes. Ironically, this was when I was notified that John Venus has eggs in his fridge by an angry vegan on Instagram. This is also when the Game Changers movie was announced. Kind of scary how when you look back on all of this, it seems really planned out and orchestrated. But at the time, you're just thinking, oh, more this, more that. You're not really thinking it's that big of a deal. The highlights for July are definitely top 10 healthiest foods, as well as the videos I did on vitamins, minerals, and electrolytes. Then Frankie Boy put two and two together, called out the carnivores for being sponsored by special interest funding, and you guys tried to crucify me. I lost quite a bit of subscribers for this, and my channel stagnated for months. And the reason I made that was because, you know, no one really wanted to collaborate with me. I couldn't figure out why. And I was trying to be objective about it and figuring out why people weren't ignoring me. And, you know, getting banned from the Reddit forum was kind of my last straw. Then we went to our second vegan event, which was by Anonymous for the Voiceless at the Cube of Truth in New York City. They did a bunch of events all over the world, and this one in New York City, you know, they were doing it for like a week straight. not much happened. Honestly, there weren't really that many people that showed up. I should have probably gone down the next weekend as well, but you know, that first weekend wasn't eventful. You know, we kind of argued with the event organizer and then they kept brushing people away from us, so we couldn't really have conversations with people. Then I made a video on the downsides of grain-fed beef, as well as a really good one on halogen toxicity, you know, the importance of removing fluoride, chlorine from your diet. We almost threw up tasting the Beyond Burger, and then answered a very popular question about carbohydrate requirements for performance. We took an in-depth look at chocolate, showed you guys what my sister eats as a carnivore, plenty of live stream Q&As, days of eating, vlogs thrown in here and there, brought up the fact that vegans are eating copious amounts of insects in their foods every day, went over raw meat safety, alcohol. Then we had the Vegan Animal Rights March, where I decided I probably shouldn't be going down to these vegan events anymore as it's risking my safety. At the time, I also did a series on cholesterol, why cholesterol is good for you, statins explained, as well as do our bodies produce enough cholesterol. Olive oil was a popular topic. I did Marilyn Monroe's diet, continued to get crucified for my weightlifting videos. This was when I started posting them here and there. Educational video on vitamin K2 was a good one. The importance of breastfeeding didn't get too many views, but a lot of people still ask me about that. The hate for my fitness videos was really ramping up at this point, in the midst of which I did several other important videos. One was on Cam Newton, where I explained why vegans can't get enough protein, another one on marijuana, and a third one on all anti-meat arguments debunked, ranging from saturated fat, heme iron, TMAO, any concern you have about meat carcinogens, you will find it in that anti-meat argument debunked video. One reason I started publishing those fitness videos was because people didn't follow through on my fitness trial, so I said, screw it, let me make the videos anyway and see what the response is. But, you know, since I was pretty skinny at the time, you know, I got a lot of blowback and I decided, let's start bodybuilding. And I've been in the gym miserable for an hour and a half every day since. Game Changers movie came out. I debunked it, you know, maybe a week or two after it came out, but most other people were really talking about it like last month, so I was a little bit early on that. I spent about 5 hours researching mushrooms for you guys. Around this point, I learned that I had high ferritin levels and started donating blood. My mother also told her medical story, having triplets, her double kidney transplant. I explained all the different types of artificial sweeteners. Then the drama ramps up a bit again. Stephanie Buttermore continuing to mislead her viewers. We took a visit to UFC 244, and I decided to expose Rat Boy for more plagiarism. Frankie's Free Range Meat at this point, you know, has been up and running for a few months. All of the kinks have been worked out. I usually went down 1 or 2 days a week to fill the orders, and then the rest of the week we would have my business partner processing this stuff. I did a parody on the American Psycho morning routine. We had a bit of fun for Thanksgiving, and I gave myself a little pat on the back for being right about John Venus. We launched our carnivore course, and then two very significant things happened that were in my favor, to say the least. One is the Joe Rogan Game Changers debate being clearly orchestrated. Another is Raw Alignment being a very obvious sellout for the carnivore diet. I mean, Chris Kresser almost threw his, you know, credibility in the toilet, and Raw Alignment made it blatantly clear that there is carnivore special interest funding. These two things convinced most people that were doubtful that there is definitely special interest funding, you know, the Cargill carnivores, shills, whatever you want to call them. You would think the vegans would have jumped on that to discredit the carnivores, but vegans don't want to touch it because they are special interest funded too. You know, it gets really fishy. You can't start calling people out for special interest funding when you're special interest funded yourself. As usual, Frankie Boy coming in hot with the information. We spoke about inflammation, avocados, antioxidants, some videos I've been wanting to do for a while. The Aga in America video was long requested, and you guys have an idea of what has happened over the past few weeks. You know, the thousands of hours I've put into my YouTube channel this past year especially is something that I hope is illustrated a bit clearer for you guys. You know, the main purpose of this video, as I said earlier, is to point out some important topics you guys may have missed, but I also wanted to explain several things. I've been portrayed as a bad guy in the carnivore community that I've never been a part of, that no one wants to work with me because I talk crap about everyone. This is absolutely not true. The only reason they are saying this is because I am whistleblowing their agenda. The only reason I am whistleblowing their agenda is because they refuse to acknowledge that this clown rat boy copied my videos. I mean, what are you gonna do? At this point, they can't just admit they were wrong the whole time. You know, they're just digging the hole deeper and deeper and deeper, and there's no ladder on the planet big enough to get them back up. Some of you might be wondering why I refuse to collaborate with Sverridge. You missed a few videos here and there. He is an absolute psychopath, and that is putting it nicely. He attacked people with knife as a teenager, has made many derogatory remarks against me for no reason other than me pointing out that he drinks water and eats cooked meat. Kind of funny, to be honest. If I tell the truth about someone and they start ad hominem attacking me, it really shows their true colors. A lot of you are asking me to respond to Vegan Gains or debate him, and I actually told myself I wouldn't even mention his name again. He is the driving factor behind my Kickstarter getting taken down, and his intentions are just as psychopathic as Sverridge, so I will not be associating myself with him in any way whatsoever. On a different note, something that was, you know, on my mind the other day, I made a video titled Vegans Are Sugar Addicts, where I pretended to have like a drug addiction and I was injecting myself with sugar. I'm not sure how many of you guys have seen that video, but let me know if you want to re-upload it because it was taken down. Of course, I have to thank you guys for sticking with me through all of this and supporting me along the way, you know, through the positive, through the negative. You know, I've done so many anti-vegan videos at this point that the amount of negative comments on my channel, you know, overwhelms the positive comments on a lot of days. I mean, I guess everything is a means to an end. You know, I always say I never wanted to make those videos, but it was an important aspect of growing my channel. And I mean, you know, whatever you have to do to get to the end goal, I guess, right? Overall, I am looking forward to a much more positive 2020. And as much as I wanted to get more done this year, you know, I have a list of like several hundred videos to do. You know, I got a decent chunk out of the way, but there's still quite a few important topics that I haven't touched on yet. You know, there's just so many random events coming up every week. I don't have time to research, you know, having second thoughts about certain videos. And it's tough because as much as I would love to just do educational videos every single day, that's not really what gets the most views. And as much as I would like to say that all of these negative things are going to be pushed to the side, you know, the vegans aren't going anywhere, I don't think the carnivores are going anywhere either. So we're going to have to deal with that. Although I would like to push it on the back burner, you know, at this point in time, it's too much. It really is too much. So thank you guys for joining me. Please like the video as always, subscribe, hit that bell icon. And if you guys want to support me further, we launched our book, Ancestral Indigenous Diet. You can check that out on Amazon. It's down in the description. And of course, you know, check out some of the videos I mentioned throughout this video. You'll definitely enjoy them. You guys, enjoy the rest of your day. See you guys next year.